We talked a lot about how you can actually do an open house, what is an open house, and now we'll talk about what are the things that you'll keep handy, or what information you'll have available to yourself whilst you do an open house, in order to ensure that people who come over there go back confident saying that this is a realtor I want to actually work with. The first information whilst you want to do your own open house is having a clear and concrete information about other listings in the nearby vicinity and locality. What happens is, when person comes to see your property and he says that this particular property is what I want to buy, and when he's talking about buying that property, he obviously wants to compare this property with other properties in the locality. Your knowledge, your information, your network of other properties in the locality, and how your property on which you are hosting an open house is better than the other properties, or how it is rightly priced compared to other properties, is important information that anyone can use for deciding whether to go for buying that open house or buying that house or not. So having clear and concrete information about other properties in the vicinity is very important whilst you proceed towards preparing for your open house. The second thing that you can also have is definitely ensure that what you can do is that what you can have is a home loan checklist. When you say a checklist for buying a new home or checklist for buying a new property, there are two small documents that any home buyer would want to have whilst he comes for an open house. Say for example, he gets a checklist for a home loan documentation process or a process of buying a new home. What he goes back home is confident that okay, I'll get a home loan worth so many rupees. He goes back educated. He feels more confident about working with you. Similarly, even if you are doing a resale property, checklist for buying a resale home is also one small document you can have just in case if you are promoting a resale property in the open house. All these small checklists or all these small documentation just ensure that when a buyer comes to the place, he feels for sure that okay, this is a realtor who actually cares for me, and he is a person who is actually going to look after my interests in the home buying process. Similarly, make sure that you are carrying a sign-in register or a sign-in sheet wherein you can capture the details of all the people who visit the open house, be it the name, the telephone number, the mobile number, or the address or the email address of the clients or other agents who visit the open house. It is very important that you register the information in a proper manner and ensure that all people who are actually visiting the open house get an update about the open house as and when things progress for it. Say for example, 50 people come and visit the open house, and out of these 50 people, say 5 people are really interested. It's also important to stay in touch with the other 45, because they are probably going to buy a home somewhere else in the near meantime. Have a huge stack of visiting cards is a must for any open house. People who come to open house, they are coming for information, they are coming for anything that can help them buy a property. And the first and primary person who can help them buy a property is you yourself as a realtor. And hence, carrying what you would call a huge stack of visiting cards is really important whilst you prepare for your open house. Similarly, preparing for the open house, you can use the RE/MAX Design Center and carry a set of property flyers or property brochures based on the photographs that you have already taken. And based on that particular thing, you can ensure that you are carrying a few printouts of the same, so that all buyers can actually get a copy of the flyer whilst they come to the open house. A simple outcome of just preparing the flyers and brochures using the RE/MAX Design Center is that your contact information is always carried in any flyers that you design, and automatically a person goes back home with your contact information on the flyer, and when he talks about this property to even his friends, neighbors, relatives, every time you are parallelly being promoted as a person who is actually helping people buy or sell homes or property in the neighborhood vicinity. Another small set of materials that you can probably carry is something like information on the RE/MAX system or the RE/MAX network, on how the RE/MAX network locally and globally can help the clients sell their home faster or maybe help in the buying process of a client. Similarly, what you can also carry is some material about your office. Now, when we talk about the office, your RE/MAX office in particular, as to what its brochure in terms of what its concentration is, what geography of real estate are they focusing on, what segment of real estate are they focusing on, and that particular information also on a particular flyer, just ensuring that you promote your office as well over there. And last but not the least, your personal USP. You could be promoting yourself in that particular place by saying that why you are a good realtor, how many years of experience do you have, what are you good in or what do you specialize in, what is your past experience, what type of businesses have you done in the past, have you done any kind of client servicing. All these small little things pulled up in a small little flyer promoting yourself can just help in the overall marketing of you yourself as a person who will actually be promoting the whole idea of the open house. Similarly, the whole idea is definitely we are looking to sell the property over there in the open house, and we are looking to service the seller in the best possible manner. Another important thing that we have to remember is we are also looking at this open house as an opportunity to attract more sellers. We are using this opportunity to promote ourselves that this is the kind of service we provide in the locality, and that's why you as a seller should also list your house with me so that I'll be able to sell it in the fastest possible time, and that's what you are trying to do. So your idea should be that in the next 25-30 days you should get one more property which you can actually do an open house, and once you do an open house, automatically you should be able to probably buy or sell that help in the buying or selling process of that home as well, ensuring that you just build your whole client database. To sum up the entire video, what we have is we began from saying that have information on other listings. So you should be aware of other properties in the area and which property is this particular open house property competing against, and what are your strengths vis-a-vis the other properties in the locality. So the second point that we talked about is preparing checklists. The checklist could be in terms of maybe the home loan process checklist or process of a real estate transaction, or checklist for buying a new home, or checklist for buying a resale home. All these are small little flyers that you can use to probably promote the home selling process and preparing the buyer to be more educated whilst he comes towards the taking the property in the open house. Similarly, moving on, what you also can carry over there is a sign-in sheet. When we are saying that sign-in sheet, ensure that you have it properly documented in terms of the name, the email address, the phone number, the mobile number, everything in a small sheet of paper or a register, whatever you are using. But the idea is ensure that you capture all the information possible. Similarly, just as a sign-in sheet, it is also important that you carry along with you a huge stack of visiting cards. Visiting cards are the best way of promoting yourself, and that's why it is really important that you carry a huge stack of them so as to ensure that anyone who comes over there gets these visiting cards and he goes back home and probably gives it to other people also. Last but not the least, also you have to remember that you have to prepare property brochures or flyers using the RE/MAX Design Center, and these flyers should always contain your contact information, your mobile number and your office address, in an effort to ensure that people always get back to you as soon as they are really interested in the property. You also can carry materials of RE/MAX, promoting RE/MAX in terms of the strengths of RE/MAX vis-a-vis the competition in the local area. You can carry material about your office as to why your office is better than the other offices in the local area. And you can also carry a personal brochure or personal flyer which talks about why you are better than other agents in the competition and other agents in the market. The idea is you are promoting yourself in this entire story to ensure that you get one more open house or one more property to sell, a client willing to list his home with you using this open house methodology. And the whole idea is that every month you are able to close one more transaction using the same systems and the processes. Thank you very much.